Hey guys, Pasty Boy here. Welcome to part two. Today we're going to be replacing a couple jets on the carbs, cleaning them up a little bit, reinstalling them. Since the last video, Mark has actually removed the rave valves, cleaned them up a bit too, so that should improve the way the engine runs. So let's jump into it.
So these are the jets I pulled out of the carbs. They don't have a number on them. It says like UBF or something. It's not a number. And then these are the ones that I'm putting in, which say 440.
Let's see if I can catch that.
And you can tell, I don't know if you can tell in the video, but the one in my left hand, this one, is a bigger hole than the one that was in there.
But we're changing out these jets. We got them from Gary, and we believe they are the stock
jets. Yeah, this is a 440. Because I looked it up, and that's what it said was stock. But this one does not have numbers. It has letters. So I have no idea what this is. So apparently he changed them, I guess, when he did the pipe.
This is the guy that we bought the sled from.
So I'm changing the pipe today, too. So we're putting these in the 440.
Right. So the guy that Mark bought the sled from piped it and did stuff to the carb and also the clutching and whatnot. So we're trying to get it back to stock because kind of feel it's going to be a better running sled. Yeah.
All right, I'm going to put the bowls and stuff all back together.
They are actually fairly clean.
Yeah. Well, I cleaned everything too.
That would explain it.
Bowls back on, and then I'm going to take apart the top. We're going to figure out how to pull the needles.
All right, so what are we doing here?
Putting the jets back in.
Okay, so these are what we believe to be the stock jets. We're going to spray a little cleaner through that before we assemble it. Give a little extra cleaning.
You don't want to torque them down too hard either.
Yeah, just a little snug will be plenty. I'm sure there's torque specs
and
on
they
this.
They are a 6 millimeter.
Okay. All right. So
sometimes putting the bowls back on, if it's cold, these are going to expand a little bit. So if it doesn't fit right, might have to take a heat gun on low and heat them up a little bit so that they contract. This one should be okay. I was screwing around with it the other day and it was actually too big. I had to take my heat gun, heat it up a little bit, and it shrunk into the mold.
Wow, that's funny.
Yeah.
I guess a new gasket would probably be preferred,
yeah,
but at this point we don't have that
luxury.
So I
do it this way because you want that gasket to sit in there, and right, if you flip it over it's going to fall out. Okay. So I actually set them in.
That makes a lot of sense.
Yeah.
You can do them one at a time.
Then flip her over.
Make sure
they sit right.
Right, it's not pinched
it's
or
not
anything.
Sticking out or anything. I had already cleaned these and stuff, so.
Right. Essentially, you're just going to spray everything out with carburetor cleaner. Sorry, we didn't get into more detail about cleaning the carbs.
17 mil. And again, not too hard. They're cast or something.
Yeah, cast aluminum.
Yeah.
But you don't want to go too soft because they could vibrate loose.
Yeah.
So use your best judgment.
And then can't forget to put the screws in.
Right.
Yeah, this one fits in.
Yeah, that was a nice fit there.
it's nice to put that bowl nut on because that keeps it in place pretty good before you get it tightened up and put the little screw in, for the most part.
Probably not a bad idea to replace these screws while you got it apart. I don't even know if I have any.
True, if there's any wear, a little Phillips head screw like that gets easily damaged if you're using the wrong size screwdriver and things like that, or they're a little stuck and then you strip them, so be careful when you're removing them if they're not damaged already. And if they are damaged and you get them off, replace them.
No, that one I had to take out with a flathead, and it went in with the Phillips. Yeah, the one, that one.
Yeah.
All right. This thing's awesome. Got a little magnet on it, too.
Cool.
A little cheap one, but works well.
Yeah. So we're going to open up the other side. Let's take a peek in there. And there's a gasket there as well that you're going to need to reuse. And we will be. All right, so we've wedged this little screwdriver in there to keep these throttles open, because we're going to remove the needles to see if they're set correctly. There's a little Allen bolt in there that's got to be removed on each one, and we're going to check that out.
All right, so I'm going to pull the needles. What you need to do is have the cam open so that the throttle is wide open, because if you look, that little Allen head, you have to loosen that. And just a couple of turns, doesn't have to be very loose. All right, in there. Looks like it already spun. There's a little hook that holds the needles in. And when I loosened it, the hook actually spun. And then literally with your needle nose, just pull out the needle. But I was looking to see if there was settings on them, but there isn't. The needle is just one groove where that clip goes.
So there's no settings for the needle that we can
see? No, not that I can see.
Okay. So apparently we're going to leave the needles the way they are. The carbs have been cleaned. Essentially, just sprayed them clean. Mark did this off camera when I wasn't here. So apologize for that, not getting in the footage. But we do have some decent footage here of this assembly and what these carbs look like inside and what you can expect.
Now you gotta get that hook over, which you gotta be careful. See, I had it under. Now it's over. Can you see the little hook there? I'm assuming, there you go. You can see it now?
Yes.
Okay, that sits over the little C-clip that's on the top of the needle. So make sure that that hook goes over the top of the needle.
All right.
All right.
So we're gonna put these back together. Gotta tighten that down again, of course. And just to clear things up, we are not mechanics, and some of you obviously you can tell, but we are handy and we like to get into stuff and figure it out, and so that's kind of what we're doing here.
All right, so just to give you an idea of what we got here, this is works like a cam, so it runs both bowls at the same time, or both sides of both carbs at the same time, and in sync. Okay, there's the needles that we just pulled. It raises the needles, which makes them smaller, all right, which allows for more gas flow. When I check these, you're supposed to start at about two turns out and adjust from there. This one was four turns out. Unreal. This one was no turns out. It was all the way in. So I don't know what happened, but I set them at two turns out, and then once we get her running on the trail, then I'll just try to fine tune it to see. But you want to start at two turns out and then work from there.
Now this thing, you never felt like it ran optimal?
No, never ran.
Got it.
Never ran right, no.
I mean, it ran okay, but not the way we expect it to.
Nowhere near as fast as it should be.
Okay, so these have to be adjusted to get it to run correctly. Mm-hmm. This one here is just for your
idle.
Your idle.
So that one you could turn in and out. It's a thumb screw. Same with these. Obviously, turn it in, the idle goes up. Turn it out, the idle goes down.
Yep. All right. So what are we doing next?
We're going to put the caps back on, and I guess we're going to start putting everything back together.
All right.
Mm-hmm.
Put the gaskets back on in place. Make sure they're lining up. There's some little alignment nubs. Or pins, I should say. On there.
You should probably drown it in gasket sealer. I'm just kidding.
I was going to say. At least he's got a sense of humor.
Yeah. I even have a sense of humor when my sled is not running.
Yeah. Broken down on the side of the trail. That's why we never go riding alone.
Yeah, never go riding alone.
I know a lot of guys do. And, you know, you could be an Eagle Scout and have all your backup stuff, but these are cold conditions and can get dangerous out there, so.
Especially when you're rolling up north.
Yeah.
You get stuck, it could be minus 25.
Yeah.
Even local, you don't ever want to go by yourself. First of all, how fun could it be?
Right.
But yeah. Then again, any day out in the snow on a sled, away from everything, is not a bad thing.
Yeah, true. It's even more fun when you have other people to ride with.
So that's that. I guess now we can start putting everything back together. So, be careful, looks like they're two different sized barrels. This one's wrapped in plastic, this one isn't. So I'm assuming the one side hole is a little bigger or smaller than the other side.
Yeah, so if you notice that, make sure you put the, yeah, I mean, obviously they will line up. You can mark them, whatever, but make sure to put the right cable on the correct side when you reassemble.
And then just put these in a few turns so it's out of your way, because it will be annoying if it keeps falling and getting in your way. All right, so get the barrel, put it in the hole. There's one. Okay. So let's tighten this up.
Did it just pop out?
No. No, that's the other one sitting down there.
Okay.
And I believe these were 10 millimeter. We'll tighten them both up at the same time. I get this other one, put the wire through.
Like you said, put a couple turns on that bottom nut, so that it's not getting in your way as you're trying to put the cable barrel back into position.
Alright, put that puppy right in. Push it up so you can get it in the slot. Boom, done. Pretty easy, actually.
Yeah, as long as you're putting them in the right side,
yeah,
the correct side, it should go right into place. Like you said, the one side had some type of plastic film on it that was a different size, and it fit into its side a lot better.
Let's see, 10 mil? Yeah, 10 mil.
10 millimeter.
That's it. A little snug. The reason the barrels won't fit, and I should have mentioned it earlier, there's one is the throttle cable. This all works in a cam, so they work both off of one cable. The other one is the choke cable. So that's why they won't fit. So even if you don't, you'll know, because this one's way over to one side, this one's way over to the other side. That's why they won't fit. This is the choke cable, this is the throttle cable.
Makes sense.
All right, so I'll show you. There's the throttle. Now look at the other one. There's the choke. Okay?
Yep.
All right, not for nothing, but I failed to mention, you want to put something in there. I just put some paper towel or some rags in there, because you don't want stuff getting in your cylinders.
Yes. Okay? All right, we're going to take the screwdriver out of that hose.
And hope no gas comes out.
Right. That's why we put it in there in the first place. And that will get hooked up. Right. Well, I'll let Mark point it out since I'm holding the light. Alright, slide that in underneath.
This way. Well, I gotta back off that thing again. So you wanna back off the clamp, because it won't go on if the clamp's in the way. So let me make sure. Yeah, so this is pointed down and goes in there. Now grab your clamp, squeeze it and bring it down so it holds it tight.
Yep.
Okay.
And if you remember, that one wasn't much fun getting off.
No, it was not.
Because it was wobbling. But it went on actually easier than it came off, which is good.
Now you've got your other heated carb lines and breathers.
They're really short hoses.
Yeah.
And you just flex them and you can get them pushed back on. If you're not sure where the hoses went or came from, just mark them before you remove them.
It should be bent and molded, so it should be pretty easy to know where they were.
Yes.
All right, now take your things out of your cylinders.
Also, taking a couple pictures before you disassemble everything can help
hurt.
Or videotape. All right, so now we have to actually connect the carbs.
Want to get on this side?
Yeah. So this part isn't going to be as hard because we don't have the air box in yet. So kind of push them back on, get them lined up, and then you can tighten up the clamps. All right, so we've got both of them seated properly. Make sure you've got them fully in before you tighten them up. So we've got the air box next, and we're done.
Let's see if we can get the box on. So when I put the carbs in, I'm gonna make a disclaimer. I'm not sure if you should or not, but I actually put a little bit of lube, like oil, in there, and it slid in so much easier. If there is a reason not to, if anybody knows, which I can't think of a reason not to, let us know in the comments. But 2-stroke oil, it's what it's gonna run anyway. I can't imagine it would hurt it.
So we put it also on this side of the air box as well, hoping that'll make it easier to install. And you got to remember to connect that electrical connection on the top of the air box before you get it in place.
you're not going to be able to see anything because I can't even see anything. So.
All right. So essentially, just reinstall it the same way you uninstalled it.
Wow, that oil works freaking phenomenal.
Except it's easy. And then you got to tighten up your two clamps. So what you're going to find easier is if you get the far one in first, if you don't have a really long screwdriver to tighten up the clamp, tighten it up, and then push the outer one in and tighten that up second.
All right, we're going to put a little lube around here so it doesn't bind up or anything, all right?
Is that some grease?
Yeah.
Nice. All right, we got to reinstall that secondary clutch. And I know on part one, a number of you guys mentioned something about how Mark had mentioned he blew three belts and that's not right. And we are going to look into that. You guys had some really good suggestions, especially Streeter's Garage there with the nun and the motor mounts and all that. There's a lot that could be going on there. And after we get the first ride in to see what's going on here, we're going to take a closer look at that.
All right, so I originally took off this clutch and put a different secondary on because I thought maybe there was a problem with the clutch of why it wasn't running right. But the truth is, with that washer in the back, this one's seated better.
Yeah, let me zoom in so on that real quick.
I'm going to use my original clutch.
Yep. Yeah, so we're going back to that. And it obviously wasn't the issue previously. It's something else. So we're going to go back. That clutch looks like it's in better condition than the one we took off in part one.
It's got a little groove.
Yep. Yeah, bring it up to here if you want to show it.
Got a little groove in it?
Yep. So that'll
seat. That's
the
part that goes in first and it seats.
.13 millimeter. Can you really get the torque you need with that?
Yeah.
Yes, that did just snap.
I knew that was going to happen. I knew it. I freaking knew that was going to happen.
That could be a huge problem. It's in there?
Yep.
Now what? All right.
All right, well.
Bolt number two.
It did snap, but this one seems longer. No, it's not. I was able to actually just turn it and it came right out. So guess who's not putting it on as tight this time?
Yeah, and we have two bolts, two extra bolts here, just in case. And we're gonna bring that second clutch on the next ride, also just in case. That's it. Okay, so right now it has a full Dynaport expansion chamber on it. And this thing is loud. And the muffler is also a Dynaport. Can't really see it too good. Let me see if I can get a shot of it here. Yeah. So it's got a Dynaport can on it as well. And this thing is pretty loud. So we don't have a stock can, but Gary had a stock expansion chamber. So we're going to put that on. Now, and here it is. Gary's not here with us, but he did give us this can. I mean, this pipe. All right, the can is fully attached, and all we have left to do is put the side panel back on. Don't forget to connect the breather hose. We've got that original secondary clutch, and I think we're going to...
put the belt on?
Yeah.
Panel?
Belt, panel, and... give it a start.
Two things you should be proud of me about. A and two. Not A and B or one and A. A and two. A, I didn't have a cigarette during the video making at all. And two, I didn't snap and burn this thing when I snapped that bolt.
Yeah. When that bolt snapped, we thought, yeah, this is... a major job to get that snapped bolt out of the drive shaft. And so, yeah. Good thing it came out, saved the day, and now we will be riding very soon. Okay, so belts on, clutch cover on, toolbox reinstalled, door on, vent hose on, and we're just going to put a little bit of fuel in each cylinder because it is completely dry now with the carbs being cleaned, and we don't want to have to turn it over 1,000 times to have it fire. So we're going to put a little fuel in each cylinder and fire it up. All right, start that thing up.
Moment of truth.
Yes. That can is still a bit loud. Yeah, it is quieter, but you can still, because it had, we got Ryan here. He's coming. We're all going. Down the street, see how it runs. His neighbor's lawn here too. Uh-oh.
I might be out of gas. I'm out of gas.
All right.
Yeah, because it seems starting back up.
Yeah. If not, I just got to turn the idle up.
Yep. All right, guys. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed the video, please give it a thumbs up. If you got a comment, please leave it down below. Check the links in the description. And we will see you next time. Take care.